Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Ivan here with IHC Suspension. And today, guys, we're bringing you a Feature Friday. What I got here behind us, this is a truck that I've been wanting to show for some time. Brand spanking new 2022 GMC Sierra AT4 US version, guys. This is not something that was bought, long bed, cut up, made short bed. This is a brand new US version. And what we're gonna be showing you guys is our full IHC 4.6 lowering kit with helper bags. So what we're gonna do now is we're out here with the media team. They're taking some awesome pictures. Now, after we're done here, let's go on over to the shop and I'll show you guys exactly what's going on with this pickup truck. Alright guys, so we're back here at the shop. As you guys can see, we have the truck here up on the alignment rack. And I'll go ahead and show you guys exactly how the parts are installed. But what I want to do first is show you the actual parts laid out here in front of me so you guys know exactly what's going on. So I'm going to break it down into three sections, guys. Pretty much what we have in the front and then what we have in the rear. But the rear consists of two parts. So what I got here in the front is control arms, and then the rear is going to be the rear 6-inch drop, and then we also have our helper back kit. But since I have this in front of me, let's go ahead and talk here. So how do we achieve the drop up in the front, guys? Remember, IHC uses custom control arms to maintain that factory ride quality. So remember, guys, we achieve the drop with the lower control arm. This is how you're gonna achieve the 4-inch drop. And then it's standard with the upper control arm. Now, on these lower control arms, guys, the way you guys are actually getting the true drop is gonna be with this strut pocket right here. This strut pocket's a little bit lower, so that's how you guys are gonna get the 4-inch drop. Now, these lower control arms, guys, you guys can see they're beefy, heavy duty. We have a beautiful silver vein, which is a nice underbody coating to make sure to protect it from the elements, especially for you guys that live upstate and deal with the snow. We got brand new ball joints. We have brand new bushings, real nice Delrum bushing, guys, for maximum performance. Thick inner sleeve to make sure you're not crushing it. And then also, guys, these control arms have to install your Zerk fittings. So they're drilled and tapped already. Zerk fittings come in a little baggy, and you guys are gonna go ahead and screw them on, and then just go ahead and do your maintenance whenever it's necessary. So we have our driver's side and we have our passenger side. Pretty much these are identical, guys. Of course, they are directional. Now, what also comes attached, guys, to the lower control arms are these right here. These are your alignment locks. So the OEM truck comes with the alignment locks. You're gonna take these off. You're gonna take off the OEM ones and install these. And these are gonna make sure your arms stay nice and put to make sure they're not moving while you guys are driving down the road. So that's for the lower control arm, guys. Now, for your upper control arms, like I said, it's standard upper control arm to make sure your alignment gets dialed in back at zero. And these upper control arms, guys, they do have a built-in ball joint angle to make sure we're getting the correct suspension geometry, although we're lowered, but it feels the same as stock, right? Make sure that ball joint has the right articulation, make sure nothing's binding on us. It is a bolt-in ball joint, as you guys can see here. So this is a ball joint with all the hardware. And the same thing, guys, these upper control arms are directional. We have our passenger and our driver's side. You guys can see we also built in the stud to make sure it holds your ABS brackets in place. Make sure nothing's slopping around. These upper control arms, guys, do come with new hardware. Reason being, and I'll show you guys, so these newer to 2019 up to 2022 didn't come with your typical frame pockets. So we do include new hardware, fine thread, and it comes with all the necessary hardware to make sure everything stays in place just as it's designed. So other than that, guys, that's pretty much it for the front. Like I said, nothing too much. It does seem maybe like a little bit's going on here, but in all reality, all we're doing is replacing upper and lower control arms and just attaching some ball joints to the upper arm, alignment locks. I mean, the ball joints on the lower, they're already pressed in, so you guys don't have to mess with any of that stuff. That's pretty much it, guys. So now let me go ahead and get this off the table, and then I'm gonna go ahead and jump into the rear components, which is gonna give us our 6-inch drops. All right, guys, so what I got here in front of me, this is the second part. This is how we're gonna achieve our 6-inch drop in the back, and then we'll jump into the third, which would be the helper back kit. So on the back end, guys, it's very straightforward. All we're doing, guys, is we're doing a flip kit, which originally your leaf pack sits on top of your differential, and what we'll be doing is with the flip kit now putting that leaf pack through the bottom, and that's how we'll achieve our 6-inch drop. And what I got here in front of me, these are all the components to do that. So in the center, guys, this is our flip kit. What it consists of is going to be our bottom plates. We have our top plates, which secure our U-bolts, and then we have our saddle, which is gonna give us our correct pinion angle. And I'll show you guys once it's on the truck. I just wanna go over it so you guys see the full layout of parts here on the table. They come with new nitrogen charged drop shocks. These are IHC, guys. We did a lot of R&D into these shocks. We're really proud of it. Nitrogen charged shocks. They handle the back end of the truck beautifully. And then we have our inner sleeve, which are going to be pressed in to make sure when you guys tighten up those shocks, we're not crushing our bushings. And then standard, guys, you guys need to run new U-bolts on these pickup trucks. OEM U-bolts are not long enough. So IHC provides new U-bolts with new hardware to make sure we're securing everything properly, guys. Now, I know some of you guys are looking at it and, hey, at a 6-inch drop, do I need a C-notch? Absolutely not, guys. On the back end, there is no C-notch required on these single cab trucks. And we'll go over that a little more in detail once I'm showing you guys the back end of the truck. So this is it, guys, for the back. Just a 6-inch drop, flip kit, drop shocks with new U-bolts. So now let's go ahead and get this off, and then I'm gonna jump into the helper back kit. All right, guys, now this is gonna be our third part, which is our final part and my personal favorite. So what you guys are looking at here, guys, this is our IHC helper back kit, which comes standard on all our 4-6 lowering kits for the single cabs, guys. That's one of the best options. So if we did not have this helper back kit, guys, that truck would be smacking a little bit more than what a customer would want on the back end. And what I mean by that is the frame hitting the axle. So with the helper back kit, guys, that's gonna eliminate the smacking. It's gonna allow you to tow. It's gonna allow you to haul. It's gonna allow you to put whatever you want on the back end without having any issues whatsoever. Still utilizing your pickup truck, although it's lowered with the nice stand. So let's get into it, guys. Like I said, this is our helper back kit. Now, I do wanna say, just before I get going here, is this kit right here, guys, is 100% bolt on. There's absolutely no drilling, no cutting, no welding onto your existing frame. Everything bolts right on. And the way we achieve that here, guys, is with these brackets here. So these are our outer back brackets, which are gonna sandwich on the frame. So as you guys can see here, and I'll show you what's on the truck. So pretty much what we're doing here, guys, this is gonna sit on the outer side of your frame. This is gonna sit on the inner side. It's gonna come together like this, and your frame slides right through the middle. And then of course we have all the hardware so you can properly secure it, as you guys can see here, to make sure everything sits the way it's designed. Now, on these helper bags, you guys can see here, this side facing up, we had to put a sticker there, guys, because we had a lot of customers that were putting it like this, and then the bag was sitting this way, which was tearing the bags on the side. So that's the reason for the sticker, if you guys are curious. And we put a lot of thought into this to make sure everything goes on correctly. We have some beautiful instructions online as well, to make sure everything's getting installed. This was just an extra step that we had to add just because we had some guys that weren't following the instructions. But to continue further along, guys, so this one sandwiches here. This is gonna be our lower bag bracket. This is the one that's gonna sit on your leaf pack. And then we have our Firestone bags, which I wanna mention, we use Firestone 9000s, which is a beautiful bag. It's been in the industry for a long time, proven, tested, and that's the reason why we use it. This bag here, guys, is pretty much gonna screw on into your lower stud. It screws on, and then, and I'll show you guys once you're further along, and then this upper one's gonna sit like this. So, and I know it might be a little bit difficult to visual it here, but I'll show you guys when it's on the truck. And then of course, guys, you need all your hardware. So we have 1/4-inch air lines, 12 feet, which is gonna give you more than enough room to route your shredder valve wherever you want it. We have our hardware to secure the bags. We have our 1/4-inch fittings, which are gonna go into the bag. We have our T to make sure you're splicing into both bags. And then we have our shredder valve, which is to air up the bag. So with that being said, guys, this is a manual setup. So just imagine the way you air up a tire, which is with our shredder valve, you're gonna air up the pickup truck. So with an air chuck, compressed air, you pump it in there. And like I said, I'll show you guys once it's further along, but this is our helper back kit here. Other than that, guys, there's not much more to it. Now let's go ahead and get this truck up off, up in the air. And then I'm gonna walk through it and show you guys everything that's, everything what I just played now on the table, already installed in the truck. So let's do that now. Truck's up on the lift, guys. So I do want to mention before we go down there, this truck, guys, we did it 2 months ago. The truck came in with about 50 miles. Right now it's a little over about 2,200 miles. So the customer does have about a good 1,700 miles on this lowering kit. But come on this way so we can see what's going on. So everything I showed you guys on the table, guys, is exactly what we installed on this truck. So remember, the first part of it was the upper and lower control arms. That's how we achieve the drop in the front. That's where we're gonna maintain the factory ride quality, because we're not messing with our strut assembly, we're not messing with our shock, we're not messing with our spindle, upper and lower control arms to maintain that factory ride quality. So as you guys can see here, guys, this is our lower control arm. So our strut's gonna attach to it. That's what's bringing the vehicle lower. We have a standard upper control arm, which you guys are seeing on the top, to make sure our alignment gets dialed in and we're not wearing any tires. This is our strut assembly, like I mentioned, our shock. This is our spring. This is where majority of your ride quality is gonna come from. And then we keep an OEM spindle. We do maintain, guys, our factory sway bar links, which may be difficult to see, but we do keep our factory sway bar links. And then, like I mentioned, on the table, and I'm gonna go ahead and just, you know, point it out because we get asked a lot. So these right here, guys, these are our alignment locks. These are the ones that sit. So if you come over here to the backside, this is our OEM alignment lock that comes from factory, and it has one on the front and on the backside. So what we're doing, guys, is we're gonna remove the OEM one, and it only goes on the side where you have your nut, and you're gonna go ahead and slide this one over. And what it's gonna do is gonna keep your lower control arm stationary because there's an alignment pin there, just to make sure that's not moving on you guys. I know that's a big thing that happens quite a bit with these control arms. In general, aftermarket control arms. So we put a lot of thought into it to make sure there's nothing moving on you guys. Make sure you guys are driving straight down the road with these alignment locks. So I did want to point that out. Other than that, guys, that's pretty much it for the front. So let's go on over to the rear. So now we're on the backside, guys. Remember, the backside consisted of two sections. We had our flip kit, which is the lower vehicle, and then we have our helper back kit. So let's go ahead and start with our flip kit part of it. We'll start on this side because we got a little bit more of a view here. So on this side, guys, this is our flip. This is our bottom plate, the one I showed you guys. What I got here in the middle, this is our saddle. This is the one that's gonna give us our correct pinion angle. And then we have our top plate, which is gonna help us secure our new U-bolts to make sure everything's put together as designed. Remember, guys, originally your leaf pack sits on top of your differential with the flip kit. Now the leaf pack is gonna go through the bottom of the differential, and that flip kit's gonna make sure everything's properly secured. On the back end, guys, which I don't think the camera can pick it up just because it's real dark. Actually, you know what? Yeah, I'll show you guys. I got a light here. So over here, guys, we do keep our OEM rear shackle, and that's how we're gonna achieve our 6-inch drop. I just wanna point that out. And then one of the questions, guys, I want to cover this because I know I get asked all the time, hey, how can I lower 6 inches in the back without doing a C-notch? For some of you guys that don't know what a C-notch is when you have to go in there, intentionally cut out a piece of your frame to make sure we're creating more clearance between our axle housing and our frame to prevent the axle housing from smacking. It gets pretty annoying if it does smack, so we do not need a C-notch on the 6-inch drop for the single cabs only. We're able to get away with it because we do have our helper back kit, which comes standard, which is I got right here. Now, I do want to point out, guys, the helper back kit sits in front of the axle. What we're looking at here, this is our driver's side leaf pack. Helper back kit's in front of the axle. And real quick, I do want to mention it because I have gotten asked, why do we do it in the front? The reason we did it in the front, guys, is because on the back side, we have an electronic parking brake, which you guys can see it over here. So I know some of the videos you guys seen out there, we have our helper back kit back here. We couldn't do that because we have an electronic parking brake and the bag is going to interfere with this electronic, and we don't want anybody having any issues whatsoever. So helper back kit sits in the front. I showed you guys our lower bag bracket, which our bag screws onto where we had that stud. And then our upper bag bracket, as you guys can see up here, sandwiches on the frame, 100% bolt on. We're not cutting anything, we're not drilling anything, we're not welding anything. Very, very user friendly, guys, for the DIY guys. And like I said, we do have full instructions on the website to make sure you guys just get clear pictures of what's going on. And then also this video gives you a good visual, right, how everything goes installed. So from the helper back kits, remember, we have one on each side. We have one on our driver's side, and then we also have one over here on our passenger side to make sure that we have bags on both sides. And then from both bags, guys, we have an airline and an airline, which go to the T. From the T, we go ahead and run the shredder valve. You can either run it to the rear license plate bracket, or you can run it over here to our fuel inlet, where you guys pump your fuel. Just open it up, and that's where the customer wanted it. He said, hey, I prefer to have it over here. So that's what they did it. And then just last thing, guys, is our IHC nitrogen charged drop shocks, which you guys can see here. Like I mentioned, guys, this customer has been running this lowering kit for about 2 months. We have had a lot of rain here in South Texas, so just minding how it looks a little bit dirty, but IHC drop shock, guys, no shock extensions, properly designed shock for this pickup truck. You guys can see up here, we have plenty of suspension travel, and in all reality, you can kind of see what the suspension travel is right here. I don't know if the camera picks it up, but it does look a little bit clean. So that's the suspension travel in the back. And then for some of you guys that may be curious how much frame to axle clearance we have, but right here, guys, this is our frame to axle. We got about a good 3.5 to 4 inches of clearance, guys, which is awesome. That's pretty much more than enough to make sure you guys are not bottoming out. We do run about 5 to 8 PSI of air pressure inside the bags, because that's recommended. What we don't want is a bag to get dry rotted on us. We're down here in South Texas. It's very hot, very humid. So 5 to 10 PSI in the bags at all times, just to make sure that you guys are not dry rotted. And that also just helps out the ride. Now, if you guys were able to put load on the truck, all you gotta do is put some air, get more suspension travel with the bags, and you guys prevent the bottoming out. But other than that, guys, that's pretty much for the lowering kit. Now, what we're gonna do is we'll go ahead and get this truck on the ground. I'm gonna put it outside, show you guys the overall stance. All right, guys, so here you have it. This is the finished product. This is a brand spanking new 2022 GMC Sierra equipped with the full IHC 4.6 lowering kit. Tire size, because I know I'm gonna get asked, guys, these are 22-inch wheels. Tire size, I'm gonna let you guys know. This guy's running a 275/40/22, which complements that wheel beautiful. The customer did do the color match and all that, guys. But like I mentioned, guys, IHC 4.6 lowering kit. Thank you guys for watching this video. Remember, if you can like, subscribe, hit that notification button. Thank you.